Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Mr. Whistler. I'm joined here by my good friend, Raucous Ron. And you are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Omaha, Nebraska, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Omaha Roller Girls. This afternoon, we're going to see the No Coast Derby Girls Mad Maxines taking on the Windy City Rollers All-Stars. No Coast coming from Lincoln, Nebraska, so don't have to travel too far to be here. And right now, they're currently ranked number 39 in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, and they are taking on the Windy City Rollers All-Stars from Chicago, currently ranked number 20.
Yeah, this would really be an interesting matchup here. You know, these two teams, one is rebuilding, the other one is really on the rise, you know, and doing some great things. So for the No Coast Derby Girls, we'll see 0 Anorexic, 0-0 Rippa, 12 Chublockma, 152 Anthrax Annie, 2992 Mia Levistich, number 3 Sly Roller, 314 Hulk Tina, 32 Flash Gloria, 34 Slam Anderson, 37 Broken Hearts, 5 Stormstress, 565 Fancy, 82 Bully McSkater, and 999 Animaniac, and that is your No Coast Derby Girls Mad Maxines.
The Windy City roster for this game, number 116, Max Savage, 138, Abita Down, 15, The Jam Burglar, 17, Mia Goham, 300, Christina Rago, 312, Killanoy, number 4 is Jan Trainer, 434, T.S. Heliot, 55, Legal Tenderizer, 5x5, Daft Spunk, 62, Mako, 622, Kidney Lopper, number 8, Iceberg, and number 88, Rita Hateworthy, Justice Feelgood Marshall, and Beth Amphetamine on the bench for Windy. About to get underway. First jammers on the Fast Girls start line. Windy will be wearing black. They're going to have number 312. That's Killanoy first out with the star. Countering for No Coast, number 32 is Flash Gloria. No Coast in white. Windy in black, and we are underway. We're seeing Flash Gloria trying to take the outside, not working out just yet. Killanoy is also up at the front, has a four wall that's kind of spread around her, closing the door time and time again. The recycling happening on Flash Gloria, now trying to take the inside line. Windy already bleeding a blocker to the Fast Girl penalty, sorry, the Derby Supply penalty box. We've got Flash Gloria up front though, first lead of the game going to No Coast.
Rather tenacious there, spinning around, fighting and then spinning around the front end.
Yep, Killanoy does complete initial pass, but the scoring is happening now at turn two for Flash Gloria. She calls it, that's a quick four, so No Coast first on the board, Ron.
Yeah, Flash Gloria, you know, former South Central tournament MVP and many years with No Coast and then switched over to Omaha for a while, now back with Lincoln, but it's just down the road, so.
Literally just down the road here in Nebraska. Jan Trainer taking her first turn with the star for Windy City. She's on the Fast Girl star line. Countering for No Coast, number 34, Slam Anderson.
Slam Anderson had a great game yesterday. Really almost pulled that one off for him.
Seeing Jan Trainer getting taken back to turn four through the infield, has to re-enter. Second consecutive lead being awarded here to No Coast, and that's Slam Anderson in charge of this jam. Star in hand for Jan Trainer. Still working her way through, has one more to beat to complete the initial. She does, but again, we've got No Coast already on a scoring run here. Slam Anderson working her way through that pack on the outside. Sharp eyes, looks over, calls it, and does call it in time. That's a 2-0 jam in favor of No Coast.
Yeah, speaking of sharp eyes, I really liked the way Slam Anderson was coming into the pack and followed the block of Sly Roller and kind of good track awareness there. Jackson Skates, more bang for your buck. See the Adam Booth for more details. Jackson Skates.
On the Fast Girl start line for No Coast, it's 999, that's Animaniac. And for Windy, number 17, Mia Goham. Bit of a slow start here. We've got Windy taking the back wall. Looks like Animaniac maybe taking a little bit of hesitation, trying to kill a little bit of time, Ooh. Get her pivot out of the box. Recycling happening on Mia Goham. Now has to work her way back up towards the front. Now again with the recycling. So far in the early going, we're seeing a little bit of trouble for the Windy Jammers to get through.
Yeah, that was Mia Leva-Stitch, and we saw that many times yesterday. Very nice recycling moves all the way to the line.
And again, it looks like we do have a first lead status awarded to No Coast.
Yeah, nice spin move around that line in turn two.
Animaniac has about half a lap on Mia Go Ham right now, so as she's about to hit the engagement zone, and absolutely flooring a blocker there. That's number zero, Anorexit.
So we'll have No Coast at 10, Windy City zero starting this one off. 26 and a half minutes remaining. Quick, roll faster and farther with Quick ceramic bearings.
New jammer on the line for No Coast. It's gonna be number 565, Fancy. And number 312, Killanoy, returning to the Fast Girl start line for Windy. Skaters are gonna start about halfway up. Killanoy trying to quarterback some defense there for herself. But what's happening here is we've got Fancy driven to the outside. She's gonna try to take the inside line. Runs into some interference there from Legal Tenderizer around lane two. Coming around turn two is Fancy picking up lead status. So far, all leads going in No Coast's favor here in the early going. Fancy with a very quick scoring pass, and that's going to be a grand slam for No Coast. She's also now on a power jam, track cutting penalty being issued to Killanoy. So early trouble here for Windy Run.
Yeah, very excited to the potential of taking down Windy City for the first time.
So another 5-point pass there for Fancy. Pack coming to a standstill over by turn three. Windy's going to take the front wall. Bit of disturbance there. Another 5-point pass, and she's going to call it. Sees Killanoy standing in the Derby supply box. So that's going to result in a power start and a big 15-0 jam for Fancy. No Coast out, 25-0 with 25 minutes left on the period clock.
And we would like to thank DerbySupply.net for sponsoring our penalty box. All your Derby needs, DerbySupply.net. Just hit it.
Justice Feelgood Marshall directing his blockers to change their formation. Seeing No Coast setting up as though they're going to go for the sweep. They do. Pays off, except for that back blocking
penalty.
Slam
Anderson will take a seat in the Derby supply penalty box.
So Killanoy was already re-entering. Killanoy getting floored there by number 82. That's Bully McSkater. Knocked to the infield is Killanoy. Killanoy now coming around outside. That's good for an initial pass.
That was certainly a bully move from Bully McSkater.
No lead awarded there to Killanoy either, so this one will go the full two. Multiplayer block penalty being issued here to number 82, Bully McSkater of No Coast. Killanoy looking for openings, not finding any. And just seeing Flash Gloria now coming up fast and hot on the inside. Completes that initial pass. Killanoy taking a lot of abuse. Getting through though, and that's a 5-point pass. Windy is on the board here. Flash Gloria still has a couple more to beat. Running, getting some help there from Mia Leva-Stitch. Flash Gloria now running into some problems. Not making a lot of headway. Still have 30 seconds left on the jam clock. Flash Gloria now comes around the outside. That's gonna complete that pass. That's a 4-pointer. Killanoy has a little more time here. Comes around the outside, but goes over the line. We're seeing this time and again. They're just working on just crushing the souls of these jammers. A lot of effort being expended here. Not a lot of damage on the scoreboard. Here is a 5-point pass.
One of the skaters for Windy is over the pivot. And taking a deep breath on the sidelines.
That would be number 15, the Jam Burglar. She's very slow to get back to the bench. Looks a little bit winded. but is skating under her own power. So result of that one, that's a 9A jam in Wendy's favor. Score 33-9 for No Coast, 22 minutes, Ron.
Bont.com, where you can find lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. Bont.com. Slam Anderson for No Coast.
And Jan Trainer with the starting a little bit further back there off the Fast Girls start line, hands the star off to her pivot.
Slam so strong, addresses that wall and just blasts through repeatedly. Very talented and powerful jammer.
Yep, Slam Anderson now back up on her feet. That's good for 5 points. Star pass has, well, the star's not on the helmet yet because we still have the pivot working on completing that initial. That's a beat of down, number 138. Now putting the star on helmet. Another 5 points do come in for No Coast. Very slow in here in the early going. Not a lot of speed from either side, unless you're a jammer for No Coast. Initial pass completed by Abita Down. And Slam Anderson driven to the infield at turn three. She's going to call it another 4 points. That's a 14-0 jam for No Coast. Timeout being called by Windy City, Ron. I think this is a good time for them to take that first timeout.
I think it is.
21 minutes left in the first half, down 47-9. They're going to do a bit of a reset.
You know, and I think that that's a good idea. I think what we're seeing for Windy City is a team that has a lot of skaters who haven't put a lot of time on the track together. I mean, you know, for No Coast, they've got these, most of their team have skated together for years. And Windy City, we all know, had a lot of transfers. They've got a lot of people, like five people have moved up from the B team this year, two from the C team. And so that coordination on the track or holding the pack together, the geometric structures, that takes time and practice and experience. And so, you know, here we've got Slam Anderson and company breaking down those walls with relative ease. And that's why you see the 47-9 score differential. But Windy City, I think if they can pull their packs together and hold a little bit stronger, that they can come out and fight in this one for sure.
Well, yeah, and they came in as the number 5 seed here this weekend.
Yes.
And if they can get things together here in this game, they can still be on track to at least maintain that position. They're still in fighting shape.
Yeah, and then you got No Coast, the number 10 seed here, looking to move up in that position and their rankings. The WFTDA took that huge loss to Helsinki yesterday, but looked in control for most of the game, kind of broke down towards the end.
Yeah, only an 8-point loss, but huge in terms of the heartbreak.
Mm-hmm.
Coming off the Fast Girl start line, and this is the first lead going in Windy's favor. This is number 17, Mia Goham, up in front. Meanwhile, Animaniac being recycled very far back here by Windy. So whatever was said in that timeout seems to have taken at least some short-term effect, and we'll see if they can keep holding on to it. Now Animaniac does get through, completes that initial pass. Mia Goham ran into some problems, was on the infield, got recycled, has completed a scoring pass. That's good for 5 points. Animaniac goes the long way around through the infield, runs into number 55, Legal Tenderizer. 2 points do come in for No Coast. Sorry, 3 points and another 5. So a double-digit jam there for Windy, Ron.
Yeah,
and now they're up at 19.
Yeah, here they go. Got a little momentum going after that timeout. And I really liked that kind of hop, skip, and jump over the apex there for Mia Goham. From the last game, we have a tweet in that says, from Boston, saying, "We love playing you, Toronto Roller Derby." And then Toronto responded back, "We love playing you, too. We'll do it again soon." So Derby love on the Twitter feed.
Yeah, we saw it on the track as well. Rita Hadeworthy now with the star for Windy City. We were told that she ran into some injury problems recently, and we weren't sure if she was going to be here this weekend in action. But there she is out on the track. And she's coming up around, picks up lead. That second lead going in Windy's favor. Fancy on the floor. Now has the star in hand. Looking to see if this is going to be stash or pass. Rita Hayworthy, though, on a scoring pass now for Windy. Taken to the outside. She's going to keep going. Looking to see if she should call it. Is not going to. Forearm penalty being issued to number 82, Bully McSkater. Heading to the Derby Supply penalty box for No Coast.
And that Bully McSkater always with a big smile on the face, even coming around to the Derby Supply penalty box.
And they've got Rita Hateworthy just shut down, except as I say that, she does spring through, and that's good for 5 points. Star Pass now completed for No Coast, putting on the Stars, game number 37. Broken Hearts coming up for a scoring pass. Rita Hayworthy calls it kind of from midair. She's supermanned into turn two. 3 points come in for Windy, and it's an 8-0 shutout of No Coast on that one. So down by less than half, 50-27, 18 minutes plus on the period clock. No Coast in the lead.
Yeah, two in the Derby Supply penalty box for No Coast. So a distinct pack advantage, 4-on-2 for Chicago on the floor.
Windy taking the back line. Killanoy, number 312 with the star. Number 32 is Flash Gloria jamming for No Coast. Both jammers run into some interference, so Killanoy is going to swing around the outside. Again, another lead status for Windy. Their game against...
There's that star pass like they did so much in the first half yesterday. And that's going to rip so tall, reaches back and gets it when her jammer's in trouble.
Killanoy calls it another 4-0 jam going in Windy's favor. So now down by only 19, 50-31, No Coast in the lead. I was going to say last night in their game against Montreal, one of the big factors for Windy in that game was the difficulty they had in achieving lead for their jammers. And now they're on a nice run. They've had three straight.
That's right.
And we're seeing, you know, that scoreboard get a little bit closer.
Yeah, and we're seeing high fives over on the bench. The team is getting fired up, seeming to find their bearings on the track. And here we go. We got Slam Anderson versus the Jamburger.
Slam Anderson with a bit of a giant head fake as she was coming off the line. Again, Jamburger picks up now the fourth consecutive lead for Windy. Windy turning things on here in the first half. Slam Anderson, star in hand, looking to see if that's going to get passed to her pivot. Broken Hearts is out there again with the stripe. Jamburger doing what she does best.
One of these moments when you really wish you could block with a three wall for Windy and give a little help to your jammer in the pack on offense. Jamburger does make it through, but now cut track. We've got another cut track on the floor for someone else.
Yep, Jamburger is going to be heading to the Derby Supply penalty box. So this is now a power jam for No Coast. No Coast looking to stop the points bleed that's been happening to them. So they do have a big opportunity here for Slam Anderson. This one is going to go the full deuce.
Multiplayer block being called on a number 55. Legal tenderizer.
Slam Anderson with the grand slam. Looks over at the bench, gets some instruction, seeing the bookends, as we've been calling them, set up here by No Coast. Now they're going to come in, see which direction they're going to sweep. Wow. As they go to strict O.
Wow, nice signal by Slam Anderson, signaling the blockers to go forward. You got to love that communication between the jammer and the blockers.
Yeah, a little shift there to a bit of passive offense, but pays off for Slam Anderson, able to keep the momentum going, spread that wall apart. So she's already racked up 10 on this jam. Power jam has ended. Jamburger is back out on the track, but now in the infield. Another 5 points. Cool. Staying corrected. That is 4 points on that pass for Slam Anderson. Jamburger now coming around the outside, stays in bounds, but then runs into Hulk Tina. Hulk Tina taking her over the line. Does put up some points, though. So Windy gets 5 on that jam, and No Coast gets 18. 68-36, just past the halfway point run.
Yeah, and the Jamburger had been shaken up earlier and went right to the locker room, was out for a couple jams. So good to see the Jamburger back out there and working.
Looks like we have an official review being called here by No Coast. So we will find out in a little bit what the nature of this review is, courtesy of Matthew Manch, our head referee.
Well, in the meantime, we want to let you know about FastGirlSkates.com. Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship at FastGirlSkates.com.
So far here this weekend, Ron, we've actually only had one rankings upset in the early game.
No Coast is contending that the Chicago Jammer never actually physically lapped them and should not have been awarded 5 points on that pass.
So there we go. So they're going to have a little confab about that. We have yet to have, we've only had one minor rankings upset this weekend, and that was actually last night when Toronto fell to Queen City. But up to this point, we've had the higher-ranked team taking every game. We'll see if that continues here.
Yeah, you know, interestingly about this one, the winner goes on to face Queen City Boston on the 6 o'clock game this evening. And then the loser of this game goes into the ninth-place game, you know, ninth-place potential game against Toronto a Sunday at 11 o'clock.
So still a lot of derby here happening in Omaha.
I really like this consolation bracket. There's you know, get a lot of more even matchups.
On review, both jam refs agree that that jammer lap point was scored before the Chicago block jammer was sent to the box. Unsuccessful review, 5 points stand.
So as a result, No Coast will not retain their official review for this half.
68 for No Coast, 36 for Windy City.
Both teams fielding jammers to get this one going. We're going to have Jan Trainer, number 4, wearing the star for Windy in black. And that's going to be 999 for No Coast, Animaniac. Jammers engaging off the start. Both trying to take the outside line. That door shuts. Animaniac still on that outside line. Again, another lead being awarded to Windy. Jan Trainer out in front. Animaniac, star in hand, hits the deck hard at turn 2. Doesn't lose her grip on the star, though. Still in hand. Jan Trainer, though, with a very quick scoring pass. 5 more points come in for Windy. Animaniac leaving a trail of downed Windy skaters in her wake as she completes her initial apex jump, though, at the end for Jan Trainer. Another successful jam for Windy, and that'll take him to 45. Gap here, only 23 points. We're on 68
Windy
to 45.
City again finding their bearings on the track, and you know, No Coast playing fairly consistently as we saw them yesterday. Windy stepping in and you know, just, you know, doing some good work on these last few jams.
Fancy on the fast girl start line for No Coast. And number 17, Mia Goham for Windy. Get one No Coast blocker out of the box, another one standing. And first lead jam in a few jams going to No Coast's favor. That's Fancy out in front. Only about a 6th of a lap, though, ahead of Mia Goham. Pack picks up the pace hard here. Windy was taking the front. And we do see a single point come in for No Coast on that one. So that's a 1-0, 69-45, 13 minutes left in the first half.
SinCitySkates.com, we wouldn't sell it if we wouldn't play in it. Been doing it for a long time.
On the fast girls start line for No Coast, number 32, Flash Gloria, and number 312, that's Killanoy for Windy. Very tight knot here. Got 4 Windy blockers up front, 4 No Coast blockers at the back. Bit of a shove there, and that's going to hit get a bunch of people on the floor. Lead jammer, though, going to Windy. It's Killanoy. Recycling happening for No Coast jammer. Flash Gloria was taken back. Takes the star off. Very quickly completes that initial. Killanoy getting the word from the bench to call it and does a 4-0 jam in Windy's favor.
Yep, Windy City 49, No Coast 69. So 20 points separating these two teams. The International WFTA Playoffs and Championships bring together the most talented skaters and teams in the WFTA. Join us November 6th through the 8th for the 2015 International WFTA Championships hosted by Minnesota Roller Girls. Live it or stream it live at WFTA.com.
We've got Rita Hateworthy and Slam Anderson on the Fast Girls start line with the stars. Another pileup. We've got 4 skaters on the floor. Slam Anderson not quite through yet. Rita Hateworthy doing the same, now surrounded by a 4 wall of No Coast blockers. Slam Anderson escapes through the front, though, picks up lead jammer.
Yeah, after having so much momentum early in the game, kind of interesting to see No Coast lose it, but maybe they'll get some of it back right here.
Slam Anderson now has one more to beat and does, getting around Max Savage. That's good for 5 points. Rita Hateworthy has one more to beat and Mia Leivestich, and she does. That's her initial. The Slam Anderson out in front, getting around the Jam Burglar, puts up a four spot.
So strong, just forcing, dipping down low, lifting up and pushing through. You know, there's a lot of ways to be a jammer and get by, and Slam Anderson definitely demonstrates how strength, shoulder strength, can help you a lot as a jammer. That's why you go to the gym. Now, you might notice that the number 219 written on Wendy's skaters, that's for Who's Your Mama, who got a concussion last night's game versus Montreal. So a little tribute there to Who's Your Mama.
They're all thinking nice things for her sake. Nice. She did go down. Jan Trainer almost survived that takeout, but did put a skate down on the infield. Cuts the track. This is now a power jam for No Coast.
So some momentum swing here for No Coast. Fancy recycled on the outside back end.
Fancy with Star in hand. Does step out, now being recycled once again. Star is going to go back on at this point. They're seeing that it is a power jam, and it's a full box right now in the Derby Supply penalty box for Wendy. Jan Trainer is standing, but Fancy, having completed her initial pass, now going for points. Four wall of No Coast. They're kind of come in for a sweep, and Fancy just goes over the line. That footwork was not quite fancy enough. Doing some zigging and zagging, though, getting around number 300, Christina Rego, and there's the grand slam for No Coast. Jan Trainer, meanwhile, encountering this four wall, very strong D happening here from No Coast. They're going to leave Fancy to do her own O, and it pays off.
Yeah, great lateral movement on both of those passes from the outside to the inside, misdirection from Fancy.
Wendy now having emptied the Derby Supply penalty box. They've got four on the floor to do some defense. Big hit there by Christina Rego, though. That's a direction of gameplay penalty for that hit on Fancy. Fancy recycled through the infield. Jan Trainer, meanwhile, coming up to the pack, hits the deck on the outside line. Another four-point pass for Fancy and No Coast.
You're up to 13 on this jam and still scoring. Woo! Look at that, that was fancy.
That was very fancy around the outside line. Five more big points there for No Coast.
And total on that jam. So No Coast now up to 96, Windy City 49. And the crowd here, you know, hometown crowd, you've got to admit, being in Omaha, Nebraska, is really big cheers for that one.
Yeah, No Coast changing the story a little bit here with the momentum.
Get all the scores, recaps, brackets, and more at WFTDA Tournament Central at WFTDA.com/tournaments.
Killinois with the star for Windy. Flash Gloria with the star for No Coast. Killinois comes around the outside hard, runs into some interference, though, goes down. And during all of that, that's going to result in Flash Gloria picking up lead jammer. Killinois now having completed the initial. Flash Gloria, though, again, evading Christina Rego. Christina Rego being a bit of a terror on the No Coast jammers, but she gets the best of that.
Yeah, 100 now for No Coast and 51, almost doubling up Windy, and certainly a momentum shift. And the bench is fired up over there for No Coast. A lot of cheers and big smiles going around on that sideline.
Indeed, Ron. Animaniac 999 on the Fast Girls start line. And we're seeing number 17, Mia Goham, wearing the star for Windy. Seeing a bit of an extra spring in the step here, I think, of the Windy jammers. Mm-hmm. And it has been paying off, although right there, nobody sees Animaniac coming up the inside line, picks up lead jammer. Mia Goham on the outside, does complete the initial, but has about 4/5 of a lap to make up. 4 points come in. Jam gets called by Animaniac.
Kind of interesting. You know, NoCosta seems to be always in the habit of shutting off the jam, but their defense is playing so well. It seems to me like if they could leave the other jammer on the track and maybe tire him out with some of their big defensive blockers, that skater like Animaniac could just lap the track a bunch of times. You know, might be a strategy that they could work on. Not that their current strategy is not effective.
Jan Trainer number 4 and number 34, Slam Anderson, other jammer on the track. A multiplayer block penalty being signaled. That's going to go to number 622, Kidney Lopper of Windy City. Lee Jammer going to NoCosta and Slam Anderson. Slam Anderson having a very strong game thus far in the early going.
Yeah, I love it when you can mix it up with different types of jammers. For instance, Slam Anderson and Animaniac definitely bring different approaches to the track. Slam now picking up 5.
Christina Rego picking up a direction of gameplay penalty, going to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. So there's now 2 blockers in the box for Windy, 1 for NoCosta. Jan Trainer with the star stash, unable to do anything with it. And it's a 9-0 jam for NoCosta.
And that'll bring us up to 113 for NoCosta and 51 for Windy City. Just under 5 minutes remaining in the first half of play. And the teams are really battling out there, even though NoCosta is in the lead. You know, Windy City is really digging deep and playing a good game. They are certainly putting in an effort on the track.
Yeah, they're going to send Rita Hayworthy, number 88, to the Fast Girls start line, facing off against Flash Gloria, number 32. Flash picks up the lead jammer. Rita Hayworthy escapes on the initial. A lot of room on the track now as we're starting to see a little more activity in that Derby Supply penalty box. And Flash Glory is going to take advantage of that and puts up a 4 spot.
On the Twitter, Julie says, Rita Hayworthy is legit one of my favorite Derby names in this game. I really hope it's a Shawshank Redemption reference. Oh, Shawshank Redemption, one of my favorite all time.
Well, I haven't noticed that they have a poster ever behind the bench. So I'd want to look behind that poster if they did.
That's right.
Number 565, Fancy on the Fast Girls start line for NoCosta. That's going to be Killanoy 312 with the 6-pointed star for Windy.
Now, big deficit of blockers on the track, and Fancy takes advantage. Lead jammer closely followed by Killanoy.
Yeah, hot on her wheels is Killanoy. She had got tangled up with some of her blockers, but with all that extra space on the track, she was able to cover quite quickly. Match race concludes with a couple of donuts. No points awarded to either team.
Yeah, we've got donuts up here on the dais. It's become a thing, so unfortunately for my waistline. So a lot of action in the last few jams in the Derby Supply penalty box. Let's see if we can clean that up, get all the skaters on the track here. That's where we want them. RideLSkates.com, made in the USA, made for Derby, Rydell Skates.
Number 34, Slam Anderson on the Fast Girl start line. Half her number is number 17, Mia Goham, jamming for Windy. Slam Anderson looks for the inside line, finds that passage closed, takes the outside, picks up lead jammer. Mia Goham, meanwhile, is kind of surrounded by a wall of white, still has a couple to beat before completing her initial. Slam Anderson now. We've got Windy doing strict D right now.
Are all you Canadians that good at math? I think it's the educational system.
It's that whole Common Core.
You're right.
Mia Goham through the outside, does complete the initial pass. Slam Anderson completes a scoring pass. That's good for 5 points. Calls it.
So now NoCosta 122, Windy City 51. It is the WFTDA's 10th anniversary, and we've been together for 10 years defining our sport with real, strong, athletic players, teams, and officials. It is revolutionaries like you that bring it all together. Happy anniversary, everyone. Here's to many more years of international roller derby play. I get goosebumps when I hear that stuff. I am really proud to have been a member of WFTDA for over 10 years myself.
I was going to get you a card, and I couldn't find the store. Rita Hayworthy coming off the line with the star for Windy, but it's Flash Gloria picking up Lee Jammer. And again, we're going to see this pace get picked up here as Rita Hayworthy has a good head of steam trying to catch up to Flash Gloria. Flash Gloria hits the pack, calls it, and does get 2 points. That's a short 2-0.
and showing that those veteran skills. Flash Gloria, head on a swivel, always knows where the other jammer is, very aware of the pack dynamic, and that's what years of veteran experience will do for you, Derby skaters. Get out there, put your time in. Someday you can be Flash Gloria.
And someone who's going to be the jammer right now for Windy, first appearance on the Fast Girls start line today is number 62. That's Mako. Lining up alongside Fancy, number 565, the jammer for No Coast. Mako looking to power her way up around and does, and picks up lead jammer for Windy. First lead jammer for Windy in a little bit, and going to take advantage as Fancy gets recycled through the infield. Star in hand, Mako with a very quick grand slam. This may be a bit of a secret weapon here for Windy. Star pass now by No Coast. It's been handed off to double zero, the pivot, Ripa. Ripa with a little skip around the turn two does steal a couple of points.
Yeah, Mako only jammed 7 times during the entire season for 14 points. So,
well, she just
It's a secret to everyone.
Well, she just picked up 5.
There you go.
Justice signaled for an official review, but it does appear that they're taking an official review as a timeout. We'll find out from Matthew Manch in a second.
Taff as a timeout.
And indeed, that is what Windy is doing. They are using their first half official review as a team timeout, so they don't have to burn a timeout. That rule change coming in the past year, and that's we've seen some people take advantage of that rule change here at the International WFTDA 2015 playoffs.
Coach Dad says, looks like Windy took some time getting warmed up, much like Boston in the last bout, but they're playing more evenly now. We'll see how it goes. They're down by a pretty good margin, but certainly time in the second half to make up that margin. Just got to put it together on several different levels, playing kind of inconsistently. Taking a look at the scoreboard right now, or the penalty board right now, we've got some skaters in a little bit of trouble over there on the Windy side. That's Legal Tenderizer with 5 penalties inside of 12 jams on the floor. So that's not a good sign for Windy, one of their key blockers. And then we've got Mako, who we just saw on the track, jamming with 4 penalties inside of 14 jams on the floor.
And we did see a point adjustment. It was actually 7 points picked up by Mako on that last jam, not the 5. Slam Anderson with the star for No Coast, picking up lead jammer. Jan Trainer, star in hand after being recycled around the outside. Multiplayer block encountered by Jan Trainer. And that's going to send a No Coast blocker to the box. And we've had a star pass. Unable to do anything with it, though, was the Jam Burglar, who received the star at the end. That jam goes 4-0 in No Coast's favor.
So the team's going to head back to the locker room here, and Windy City certainly has some things to talk about, try and come out and recapture some momentum. We saw them, though, get some momentum in the game earlier, and if they can make that more consistent, and it's like we were watching No Coast, pretty consistent across the board. Rarely do they drop the ball. It really hurt them yesterday against Helsinki. I don't see No Coast really faltering too much in this one. So it's going to be up to Windy City to really play up to their level.
Yeah, and we've seen it happen a few times already here in the early going, where we've seen Windy do a bit of a reset, start chipping away, and then a wheel comes off somewhere and No Coast goes on a bit of a run. But right now they're up 130-58.
That's right. We're
going to probably bring you some stats and some other fun stuff here at end of halftime. So stay tuned. You're watching WFTDA.tv. And welcome back. You are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division I playoffs here from Omaha, Nebraska. I'm Mr. Whistler. Raucous Ron sitting by my side, our producer Double H with us as well. We are here seeing No Coast taking on Windy City. No Coast coming out of halftime with a lead 130-58. Starting to look at some of the statistics to see what kind of interesting numbers we can throw at the good people.
You know, the stats are interesting. I'd like to point out that we're seeing a lot of fight from both these teams. They both lost yesterday. They really want this win today. No one wants to go out, you know, zeroed in a tournament. So definitely some feisty play out here. And speaking of feisty, how about Slam Anderson with 61 points here? Oh, getting a look at the whiteboard on the track there. I know a lot of people like that. Slam Anderson with those 86% lead percentage, and that is fantastic for the team, and zero penalties on the day. So that's that experience and time that's working out for No Coast. We've also got Fancy with 36 points, Flash with 22, and Animaniac with 11. But Animaniac has a 60% lead, so and negative 8 differential for Animaniac. On the track for Windy City, we see 17 points for Killinoy, their top scorer. Not too much to speak of other than that, spread around a little bit. Definitely need to get on the ball with the scoring and playing a little bit more offense. A couple skaters in trouble there. Legal Tenderizer with 5 penalties, Mako with 4, and Christina Rago with 3 as well. So that's a little look at our stats there. Are calling those penalties on the floor. Our crew head referees, Matthew Manch, DJ Chaotic, Colin Deschatz, Mike Hammer, Major Wood, Stabby McDudebro, Julius Caesar, and PH Diva.
And we are ready to get underway here for the second half. Again, score 130-58 in favor of No Coast. No Coast in white, Windy City in black. Windy City with Mia Goham wearing the 6-point to Jammer Star, but Lee Jammer going to Flash Gloria and No Coast. Flash Gloria now on a scoring pass. Mia Goham still trapped at the back. Mia Goham now sprung around the outside. Flash Gloria completes the pass, gets the instruction from the bench. It's wavering. They're going to let her go. So she has put up 5 points. Now is going to call it, run a little bit of clock down. 5-0 jam in favor of No Coast.
So No Coast continuing where they left off going into the second half there with some momentum. WFTDA.TV, you know you don't want to miss a minute of championships. Get your WFTDA.TV watch pass now for only $22.50. Live it or stream it live on WFTDA.TV.
And that's going to be a very exciting tournament next month in St. Paul, Minnesota at the beautiful, legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium.
Yeah, I am looking forward to it. I have not missed one in many, many years.
Slam Anderson on the Fast Girls start line for No Coast. Countering for Windy is Jan Trainer. Multiplayer block penalty being issued there to, I believe it's Rita Hateworthy of Windy. Lead Jammer going to No Coast.
And strong with that shoulder again past the Jam Burglar, just forcing straight through. No lateral movement needed. And again, same thing.
So we're seeing almost a traditional power jam formation here by the No Coast blockers. The 3 on the inside line, the 1 on the outside as they set up. Now coming in for this sweep. Beautifully executed. Slam Anderson puts up a 5 spot.
Brooke and Hearts with that positioning coming into the pack just cleared out 3 blockers at once.
And when I say it's a traditional power jam formation, that would be because it is a power jam. We've got Jan Trainer in the box for a back block. So only Jammer on the track is Slam Anderson. Gets around Jam Burglar, calls the jam as Jan Trainer stands in the Derby Supply box, puts up another 5, 15 on that jam in total for No Coast.
Yeah, not how they wanted to start the second half here, losing a couple of lead jam calls and the jammer to the penalty box. Jan Trainer now standing with the helmet cover in her hand.
So the power start, we're going to see number 565. That's Fancy in white for No Coast. Only Jammer to start this one from the Fast Girls start line. Getting some nice offensive help there from her blockers. Just gets reabsorbed, though, as Windy negotiates their way up to the front. Trainer back on the track as well. Both jammers eligible to pick up lead jammer at this point in time. Fancy swings to the outside, picks up lead jammer. Jan Trainer now looks to take the same route, finds an obstacle, can't get through on that side, takes the inside, just stays in bounds, completes her initial pass, Fancy getting some help there from double zero Ripa. Her pivot puts up another 4 points.
Get all the scores, recaps, brackets, and more at WFTDA Tournament Central. That's WFTDA.com tournaments. I know I'm following along all the time. Got to have that info coming in. I'm like that guy at the ball game in the top seats getting the reception from the radio station.
Oh, the guy with the plastic helmet with the beer cup stuck on
that's
the sides?
Right.
That guy, yeah. That's you. That's you, Ron. 3-1-2, Killinois. Wearing the six-pointed star for Windy, the five-pointed star for Nokos, that's number 32, Flash Gloria. They are the Jammers. Lots of physicality here to start the second half, seeing some bigger hits, some bigger action on the track. Flash Gloria pushing and separating these Windy blockers, blitz them up enough, gets through for lead. Number eight going to the box for Windy, that's Iceberg for a forearm penalty.
Yeah, Nokos looking to be in control right now in the second half. They have pretty much owned the scoreboard so far. Nokos 156, Windy City 58, 25 and a half remaining. The WFTDA would like to thank Derby Central. We have some great sponsors. We should take care of all of them. They take care of us. It is one big Derby family, and I know I do. I go around at these tournaments and buy something from every vendor and tell them thank you for being here.
Well, make sure you pick up something nice for me, Ron.
Mm-hmm.
Coming off the Fast Girls start line, number 88 for Windy. That's Rita Hayworthy, but Slam Anderson picking up lead jammer quite quickly. Lots of activity in that Derby Supply penalty box, so it's leaving some extra space on the track. Jam Burglar very quickly getting up front there. The pivots trying to quarterback some action.
A little excitement there on the floor. Slam Anderson falling down and laughing at herself. Good yes. Sportsmanship.
Well, that was a big takeout there, courtesy of Mike Hammer in the stripes.
Yeah, you've got to appreciate a good hit no matter what team you're on. I know the folks at in Lincoln who aren't here are watching on WFTDA.TV. If you'd like to get to us on Talk to WFTDA.
On the Twitter. Yeah, Mia Goham jamming for Windy. Animaniac, though, with a nice inside-outside move, picking up lead jammer for Nokos. Nokos is picking up where they left off. Mia Goham completes her initial pass. Windy taking the back and getting some help there is Animaniac as number three comes in to mess things up. That's Sly Roller. And we do get Windy on the board. That's a point on that jam, but three come in for Nokos.
Whistler, did you know, and I know you know, the WFTDA is celebrating 10 years of leadership in modern roller derby, and those 10 years has grown from 20 founding members to more than 400 leagues on six continents.
I feel like I've heard something about that.
You've heard that before?
Yeah, there's been a rumor in the wind.
That's right.
Right now on the Fast Girls start line, we're going to have number four, Jan Trainer for Windy. Flash Gloria wearing the star for Nokos. Jan Trainer pushing up the inside line. Unable to get through, though. Gets passed by Flash Gloria, who's going to pick up lead jammer for Nokos. The Mad Maxines in the driver's seat at the moment. They've got a lead of 104 points, 23 minutes left in the second half. Flash Gloria adding to that lead with a five-spot. Jan Trainer doing a bit of engagement, star in hand. Another five come in for Flash Gloria. Jan Trainer now being taken back by Bully McSkater with the drawback, taking her back almost to turn one. It's about turn one and a third. Flash Gloria now around the outside. Jan Burglar and Christina Rago, the last lines of defense. Rago with the takeout over the line, unable to do the drawback, though, as Ripa comes in to prevent that activity. Track cut being issued to Christina Rago. She's going to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. Mako has to let Flash Gloria go, who puts up five more points, Ron.
That's right. Definitely making short work of the pack, the reduced pack for Windy City, easily getting through on that one.
Jan Burglar trying to get into position, see if we might get a star pass.
It is Flash Gloria.
But Drake taken to the infield while Flash Gloria continues to lap her opponents. Jamberger does now have star in hand, unable to break free though. Flash Gloria comes around for another pass, and she is just racking up the points on the stat sheet, Ron. She just put up five more. That's a 30-0 jam.
Yeah, 30 points on that one for Megan Harrington, also known as Flash Gloria. Megan Harrington is a lifer. If you want to be a lifer, get a lifer. S1 Helmets at s1helmets.com. Man, oh man. So Megan Harrington now 70 points, I believe, on the board. So a timeout for No Coast called right now.
Actually, it looks like it's probably being called here by Windy.
Yeah.
So they're going to make that adjustment on the scoreboard. So, yeah, Windy is going to take this as a team timeout. I think anytime you've got a 30-0 jam, go up against yourself where it was not a power jam, that's a good time to call a team timeout, do a bit of a reset. So that's indeed what Justice has done. He's got the whole team gathered around the bench here. Hands coming in. Again, we talked before about how they are for this game without...
Yeah, who's your mama?
Thank you. Yes. Who's your mama? I'm seeing the number, but of course she's not on the game roster because she's not playing. She suffered a concussion last night, apparently. Justice actually has the 219 written across his throat.
Oh, my goodness.
He's very old school today. Number 34 on the jammer line here. The Fast Girl Star line, that's Slam Anderson wearing the star for No Coast. Killanoi, very slow start here. Killanoi just with a very, I guess I'll turn around and try to work her way through the inside. Goes down in a heap with a lot of other people on the outside. This was going to be a power jam, but now both jammers going. Killanoi trying to get to the box first, so she have a split second advantage. She goes for a track cut and a forearm penalty going to Slam Anderson.
That would be the first penalty of the day for Slam Anderson, so playing very clean in this one.
So no power jam to speak of here. It happened so quickly. So this one's going to go full 2 minutes. Star in hand for Killanoi.
Killanoi digs right in the middle and falls down. Gets a penalty. Was that blocking with the head? Yep.
So this will be
coming.
An actual power jam now in No Coast's favor. Slam Anderson, only jammer on the track. Killanoi has now got to get to the track. Sorry, get to the Derby Supply box. Slam Anderson comes around the inside line. One more to beat, and Rita Hateworthy.
Boy, that's the full package. Footwork, strength. Slam Anderson's got it all.
Box trouble here for Windy. Theirs is a full. They've only got one skater on the track. That's Rita Hateworthy. Rita Hateworthy at the mercy of No Coast now. We are now starting to see the box empty just a little bit for Windy City. But this is going to be a painful one as Slam Anderson comes around for another five. Windy starting to get back on the track, though. Killanoi coming up. Star is stashed, but not passed. That is an initial pass now for Killanoi. Jam time runs out. Net result there is an 18-0 pickup for No Coast, Ron.
And the wheels falling off the bus for Windy City here in the second half. Really not scored. It's 1 point in the second half to bring them up to 59. No Coast on an explosive run here. 2-11 on the board. 18 points on that last jam. 19 minutes remaining in the game. So they've got to get the crew out, the repair crew out there for Windy and get the wheels on the bus.
Well, what they're doing right now is they've put Mako back out on the Fast Girl Star line with the star, number 62, and paid off earlier in the first half. It was just the 1.5 scoring passes as she went 7-2 on that one.
Almost.
But yeah, now No Coast with a healthy complement of blockers causing her all sorts of trouble. Fancy, meanwhile, same thing. She's stuck at the back. She's wearing the star for No Coast. And Mako picking up lead jammer for Windy.
Yeah, I had to fight past that block of Ripa. Speaking of Ripa, now with the star pass from the jammer for No Coast.
Mako taken to the outside, goes over the line, then she calls it. And that's a 2-0 jam for Windy.
So there you go. A couple more points, you know. The opposite of the announcer curse. They only scored one. Let's get some more out there. But I think Mako was the secret to that one, actually. And that might be what they need, is someone with some strength out there to push through. And speaking of which,
they're going to send Christina Rago out with the star now. So another skater we haven't seen yet on the Fast Girls star line for Windy. They're sending Rago out with the star. She's going to face off against 999 Animaniac for No Coast. So Windy's starting to mix things up a bit, see what they can make happen. Star pass, though, in progress. Jan Trainer is out there with the pivot stripe, has now received it, is now the jammer. But while that happens, Animaniac picks up lead. But Windy has sprung their jammer, and that's going to be an advantage for them.
Yeah, Animaniac through, picking up four, or make that five. And we'll see Broken Hearts headed to the penalty box for No Coast.
So two more points do come in for Windy on that one. So that's two jams in a row, which they've scored. And that's a nice momentum shift for them. And I don't mean to make it sound like that, like, oh, they've scored two jams in a row. But
you've
given how this
somewhere.
Half was starting, we're starting to see things kind of work in their favor a little bit.
Changing their approach, trying some different things. You know, if it ain't broken, don't fix it. But if it is, do.
Rita Hateworthy looking to see what she can do on the Fast Girls star line. Legal procedure penalty, though, being issued.
This happens when you put jammers out with very little experience like that. Get these kinds of problems.
So this will be a power jam for No Coast and Flash Gloria. Only jammer on the track is Rita Hateworthy. Unfortunately, has to take the long way around to get to that Derby Supply penalty box and start that penalty. Right after she sits, the first five go on the board for No Coast. So they've got some time here to add to this lead. And we're seeing the switch there happen very quickly. It's, again, about a one or two count. And then they come in to do the sweep, not making Flash Gloria have to do as much of that heavy lifting on the power jam.
Great footwork out there for Flash Gloria. Just incredible. And that's the thing in a game like this. You know, we've got 228 to 63. There's a lot to watch and learn from these veteran skaters out here on the floor. I'm really enjoying watching the action, especially the growth of No Coast. They have really come together as a team, playing solid offense and defense, kind of putting the whole package together over years of working together. And I'm sure they're happy to see it too.
Well, and they've had a long run at playoffs. They've made, you know, Division I playoffs or South Central playoffs previously every year since 2009. Earlier this year, they were down in the high, you know, the 40s briefly in D2 territory, but they came back in.
Yeah, and we've got Chu Bachma on the first jam of the game for her out on the floor picking up lead jam for No Coast. So No Coast feeling confident enough to send in some inexperienced jammer themselves. Me get a little experience on the track. You can't always lean on your Flash Glorias and Slam Andersons.
Indeed. So no points come in on that one, but does eat up a little bit of clock time. Score holds 228 to 63. And we are going to see some jammers coming out. And what do you got for us, Ron?
Well, the WFTDA recognized tournament program supports high quality tournaments hosted by WFTDA members worldwide. If your league is hosting a tournament this year, learn more about this program and apply at WFTDA.com/events.
Mia Goham and Slam Anderson, the jammers right now. It's Slam and Ham. Slam is the first one through, though, is lead jammer.
I'd like to slam and ham about now.
Mia Goham shortly closes the gap. Woo! Apex jump puts up 4 points for Windy. Nobody keeping an eye on the inside line. That was a beautifully executed apex jump there for Mia.
See, and then over here from the bench for Windy City, you know, down, but they're not out there celebrating those small victories. And that was a fun one. Team giving lots of fist bumps.
Yeah, so Windy, I mean, we know, Windy knows. It's been a bit of a rebuilding year
as the year
has gone on.
Everyone knows it. But, so no shame in that.
No, and they're doing some tremendous things right now as they're mixing things up. They're putting Killanoi back out on the Fast Girls start line, going up against Fancy. Fancy does have an advantage here. Has one more to beat, hits the deck. Now taken by two. Stuck at turn two, coming down the outside of the far straightaway. And meanwhile, Killanoi, trapped at the back, has four no coast blockers to contend with. And they have a track cut being issued to Killinoy. Power jam going to no coast. Fancy also is lead jammer. Lead jammer, only jammer, power jammer puts up 5 points there on that pass. Everybody's setting up here at turn four. Windy taking the front. Got a 2-1 formation at the back of that pack for no coast. Looking to see if they're going to come and split things up. And they're mostly trying to trap Jam Burglar wearing the pivot stripe for Windy at the back. Skating through the infield and coming down, not going out of bounds, or rather not cutting the track. That's Fancy, calls it, another 5 points, a double-digit jam for No Coast.
Yeah, and No Coast, a nice balanced approach with their jammers, a real steady rotation, everyone getting a lot of action out there, a little bit more for Slam Anderson and Flash Gordon. You can see that on the scoreboard. Slam Anderson with 100 points now, Flash with 72. We've got Animaniac with 18, relatively low, but and then Fancy with 50.
So Windy sending Christina Rago, number 300, back out with the star, facing off against Flash Gloria. Neither jammer across the pivot line until just about now. Flash Gloria looking to take the inside line, gets pushed over, but not drawn back. High blocking penalty being issued, number 0, that's Anorexit for No Coast. Lead jammer going to No Coast as well, and Flash Gloria. And Christina Rago handing off to Rita Hateworthy, but Rita Hateworthy has to go whack back to the back to re-enter. But star pass now completed. Scoring pass completed for Flash Gloria at the same time. So far, jam going 5-0 in favor of No Coast. Jammers now slowing down and engaging at turn two. A bit of cat and mouse happening. Jam called from the floor and does call it in time. No more points on that final pass for either side.
Tell your friends and family you're busy watching Derby with the WFTDA. Do not disturb image. I need to get that. Find them at facebook.com/WFTDA. That would be the whole weekend for me. When I watch these tournaments, I got to watch it. You know, I'll take the day off on Friday or work from home, watch it all weekend long, Twitter in, you know, yell at the announcers, tell them how awesome they are.
Yep, and you're probably doing that using the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA.
That's right. Yeah.
Mako and Chewbacma, the jammers right now. Chewbacma, number 12, jamming for No Coast. Mako, number 62, jamming for Windy City. Both teams now starting to put out less commonly used people in these positions. But both jammers now also going to the Derby Supply penalty box. Track cutting penalty issued against Mako, and we have a back blocking penalty issued against Chewbacma. So they're each going to take a short sojourn in the Derby Supply penalty box, waiting to see who gets released and when. Both released. Pack lines up between turns 2 and 3 on the far straightaway. Jammers are together. There's a split off. It's almost as though they each split off, like, I'm going to challenge this pack, you're going to challenge that group of the pack. Chewbacma gets through first. That's her initial pass. Star pass to Killinoy, the pivot, or former pivot, of Windy. Direction gameplay penalty being issued to Anorexit, number 0 for No Coast. Star pass is now completed. And Killinoy putting the star on helmet.
And we're seeing the first points of the tournament scored for Chewbacma.
Killinoy cuts the track, going to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. Power jam now for Chewbacma. Chewbacma only got 2 points on that pass, the way everything was falling down.
Bachma's real name, Tanya Bachma, so good play on the real name there.
And just like a Wookiee, putting up 5 points there. 7-0 jam going in No Coast's favor. Justice Feelgood Marshall coming out to have a quick word with the officials. 2 points actually do get called in for Killinoy and Windy City.
And on Twitter, hashtag talk to WFTDA. Jenny Peterson says, no coast, no mercy. And we're seeing that right here. That's one of their chants at home. If you've ever been there and seen them play, which I have many times and announced with the guys there, the crowd is avid Derby fans, and they will scream that chant over and over again.
Track cutting penalty being issued to 152. It's Anthrax Annie of No Coast. Slam Anderson up at the front with the star for No Coast, but picking up lead jammer, it's Killanoy of Windy City. Killanoy coming around already on a scoring pass. Ripa lining up in wait. Now we've got a three-person trail being dropped here around the back as the triangle split into a long baseline.
And good defense on the front end. They've got to get some things from this game to work on or to take note of. And that defense up front is one of them. I hadn't seen a lot of that before with the good geometric structures, and there was one.
Well, yeah, we had Rita Hateworthy there with Christina Rego, the two of them going shoulder to shoulder, right, closing that door. Finally got wedged apart. Strong efforts there by No Coast to get that split up.
Yeah, and that's what you have to take from a loss like this is work on those individual things that you did well and move away from it, not be too discouraged, because they have another game to play tomorrow. That is looking like it's probably going to be Toronto for the number ninth place slot at this point, with only 6.5 minutes remaining. No Coast 252 and Windy City 73.
Number 17, Mia Goham wearing the star for Windy. Animaniac, triple nine for No Coast is the other jammer. And everybody just coming together. Again, we're seeing Windy starting to get a bit tighter on this defense. Animaniac, though, trying to push things apart. Now gets the help from her blockers, takes inside line, picks up lead jammer. Mia Goham, meanwhile, being dragged back by number 32, Flash Gloria. Flash Gloria doing some blocking now. Ripa emerges from the Derby supply penalty box. Power jam is going to be very short-lived. Track cutting penalty going to Mia Goham.
And skating out of bounds for Animaniac. So a little switch off here and back on the track.
So another two-minute jam in progress. Still have a minute plus left on the clock. Mia Goham back out, as is Animaniac. Animaniac sailing through the infield here, and now he gets drawn back. Animaniac coming around the outside. That's going to be good for 4 points. Mia Goham now zigging and zagging, taken out through the middle there by Anthrax Annie. Still have 5 minutes left on the period clock, just under half a minute on the jam clock. We do have those two clocks side by each. 9:99, Animaniac scoring again for No Coast, going back for more. Mia Goham, meanwhile, trying to come around the inside line, just gets knocked into the infield there. A back blocking penalty being issued to Ripa, the captain and pivot of No Coast. Jam clock about to run out, and it does.
And that big hit was courtesy of Flash Gloria. And another great thing about great teams like Texas is that the players can play all positions. And you see that on No Coast where they're playing, you know, the jammers will come out and do some different things. And again, the experience of Noco shining through in this one, 265 to 76 over Windy City with just over 4 minutes remaining.
Fancy and Rita Hateworthy, the jammers to start this one. But it's going to be a power jam going for Windy. Rita Hateworthy, only jammer on the track right now, also lead jammer. Fancy picking up a forearm penalty right off the start, taking a seat in the Derby supply penalty box.
Wow. And they tried to sweep to the outside with the No Coast blockers, but astutely, No Coast standing on the inside line, preventing it. Now we have a cut track for Rita Hateworthy, so that'll end this power jam, but already standing in the box is Fancy.
So that means Rita Hateworthy's going to have a bit more time than she would like in that Derby supply penalty box. Fancy comes back on, is on, and cuts knocked over the outside line just there by Daft Spunk with the drawback. Now Fancy looking to negotiate her way down the straightaway. Windy trying to set up with that four wall, working on a diamond. Noko's having none of it though. They're trying to disrupt it. There are some repeated recycling happening here. And now everybody just kind of locked in between two and three. Fancy now drawn back again, now going to the infield. Rita Hateworthy back on, encountering Nokos, who has now taken the front wall. They are stuck at turn three. We've got the officials on their knees looking to see who is doing what. They've got the eyes on the prize. Direction of gameplay penalty coming in on number 2992. That's Mia Leva-Stitch. Star pass by Windy. Jammer is now going to be Mako. Mako completes that pass, has scored. A low blocking penalty coming in for Daft Spunk. People hitting the deck. That one got a little sloppy towards the end, Ron. Scoreboard showing 271-76 though.
You know, and it looks like we're going to see the 10 seed take down the number 5 seed. Number 39th in the WFTDA take down number 20. That's a pretty big upset right there, Mr. Whistler.
That's certainly going to be the biggest upset we've seen this weekend. It's only the second rankings upset. So it's an upset on paper. Nokos, though, certainly, they may actually be slightly underranked from what we've seen to them this weekend.
Yes, I agree.
And, Windy, of course, a team in flux, still doing great things, but right now they're trying to get Kidney Lauper through. Kidney Lauper is the jammer right now for Windy. Nokos is countered with Chewbacca. Chewbacca has picked up lead jammer. Just over a minute left on the period clock. Kidney Lauper does complete her initial pass. Chewbacca completes a scoring pass. Jam's going to be called here.
Wow, and we will end up seeing Nokos later today at 6 p.m. versus Queen City from Boston. And that should be one. Oh, no. Yep. From Buffalo, of course. Thank you very much. Queen City from Buffalo. That should be a really good matchup. No Coast in the first game yesterday. I lost by 8 points to Helsinki, the number 25th ranked team. So played them very close, in control most of that game. I'm excited to see them against Queen City.
And bringing this one home, we've got Slam Anderson wearing the star for No Coast. Mia Goham with the star for Windy. Mia Goham is through. There's the hand signal, is Lee Jammer. Slam Anderson completes their initial pass. But a track cutting penalty issued to Mia Goham. This one's going to run the clock all the way down. Power jam for Nokos. Slam Anderson, only jammer on the track at the moment.
Yeah, we'll go the final minute and a half here with no lead jammer. And Slam Anderson on the track with a chance to extend her points from 105 and beyond, make it 110.
Yeah, having a phenomenal game is Anderson. She's got 10 on this jam already. Still 1 minute remains on the jam clock. Slam Anderson goes down in a heap, courtesy of Jan Trainer between turns 3 and 4.
Fighting down to the bitter end here. Boom, huge hit from Flash on to one of the Windy blockers.
Yeah, it's T.S. Helliot. Boom goes the dynamite courtesy of Flash.
And it was on purpose again. Boy, Flash just is aggressive on the floor to the very end of the game.
291-85, 30 seconds left on the jam clock.
No Coast, no mercy. They continue to roll right here.
And Mia Goham had re-entered play, but unfortunately cuts the track. Power Jam will run this one down to the final end. Slam Anderson, again, only jammer on the track. Mia Goham will barely have time to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. Final big collision there at the end. Slam Anderson
Wow.
goes down hard. with Mac Savage of Windy. Mac Savage, though, up on her own power. Looks like that one didn't feel so good, but yeah. What felt good there for Slam Anderson, though, was bringing that one home, a 23-7 final jam for No Coast.
Yeah, and big cheers from the crowd here in Omaha, Nebraska. They are psyched up, really pumped about this team and about the future of this team. Now going on to Battle Queen City for an opportunity to play in the fifth place game. And that would be incredible coming into this tournament as the 10th seed to go out as the fifth seed for them. So still opportunity and hope for that. We'll see Windy City go on to face Toronto tomorrow at 10 a.m. for the ninth slot. So still an opportunity for a win for Windy City here against Toronto. But you know, Toronto's hungry. I'd like to point out that in that game and that Windy had 14 jammer penalties while No Coast had 5. So that'll make a huge difference on the scoreboard right there. And that goes to their inexperience on the track.
Well, for sure. And it's something that, of course, is going to get better with time. Lead statuses also, lead jammer continually going to No Coast.
Mm-hmm.
We've got less than 10 leads that went in Windy's favor. And there's a lot of numbers over on the No Coast side of the stats screen. So it's going in the books, 299-88. Final, look at the tally here.
Yeah.
We've got so many points on that board.
So many
Slam
points
Anderson
on here.
With 119
for No Coast. Flash Gloria with 77 on that side. Anna Maniac with 37. And Fancy 55. Yeah, in a minute here, we're going to go down for the interview, and Megilla Gorilla will interview Kelly Ripa, the co-captain of No Coast. It's coming up right after this game. We're going to see the Nexus Jazz Choir. Good stuff. All right, we're going to throw it over to the interview.
Got here early, so
that's okay.
That's good, right? We are live trackside here. I'm Megilla Gorilla alongside of Ripa. Congratulations, Ripa, captain of No Coast. They just beat Windy City in a really, really fantastic match. But I'm going to take you back. I'm sorry. I got to be mean. I got to talk about yesterday, okay? Rough ending to that game. Where was the team at mentally, emotionally after that win?
We felt really good about how we played. I mean, at this level, there's no margin for error. And we made a couple of errors in the second half that cost us that resulting loss. I still feel like we came out today with a lot of energy and a lot of fire, and everybody felt real good about the way we played yesterday.
And so today, what did you guys do that was so effective? It looked like you guys were dominating at both sides on the track, offense and defense.
Cube, reform, and watch our edges, and that's all we did all day long. Just cover the edges, cube, reform. And then we eventually know that they're going to have to peel off and play O, which frees up our jammer even more. And as long as we can continue to do that throughout the game, keep four girls on the floor, as many as we can out of the box, we knew we were going to win it.
Came in as the 10 seed, though. You're playing at, it seems like, a different level than you guys had previously when you come into that seed. What was your goal this weekend as a team?
Well, I think there's a lot of European teams in the tournament this year, and it kind of shook up the rankings a little bit. And so I think from tournament to tournament, that's all kind of been unraveling and unfolding, and you can kind of see where everybody really is placed. I think we got a low seed, but, we're used to that, and we're used to coming from below. And, we got fifth place in our crosshairs, and that's what we're aiming for.
Well, you've got another game today. Good luck against Queen City. Much of the same defense, same offense, and we're going to expect to see the same stuff.
If it's working, I don't think,
why change
don't
it?
Fix what's not broke.
That's right. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Go rest up with your team. We'll see you on the track later on. Thanks. That's Ripa from No Coast. Thanks for watching WFTDA.TV. We got Montreal and Gotham, the first semifinal of the game coming right up.